Hey, wow, look at all this stuff. It's time for another mailbag. Get this out of the way. We'll start with that one, I guess. Where's my knife? There we go. Okay. Here we go. What is this? Quantity 2, description of contents 1, AP 33*1. Okay, what do we got here? A variety pack of LEDs. Okay, if I remember correctly, these are four colors, red, green, blue, white. Cool. Always handy to have a bunch of LEDs in stock. As you just never know when you're going to want to light stuff up. So what have I got in stock so far? Got some, actually, I've got mostly 5mm in this one and some surface mounts. And in this other little case, got some 3mm and some oddball 5mm and these strange little side address ones. These ones are some, here are some really, really old low intensity LEDs. I mean, that's really, really dim compared to the more modern one. Put that into the 20 milliamp slot as well. Much brighter. But those are 5mm. These new guys are all 3mm. So that should be a nice assortment to add to the collection. Cool. Okay, 100 piece slot, 3mm white, green, red, blue, yellow LEDs. So, 5 colors, so 20 of each in 3mm. Yeah, that looks a lot like the pile that I got. It was this Hot Cell 7 for a whole $1.12 Canadian for the 100 of them, which would be 99 cents American. And yeah, not much more to say about those 3mm LEDs. All right, next, this one's got either Customs or Canada Post has been sticking these barcode stickers over top of the customs declaration. So I don't get a clue of what's in there. Well, we can all be surprised. Again, with the foam stuff. And another elastic. What do we got in here? Aha! More prototyping boards. Which type are these? Are these... No, those are still... More dots. What have I got? Are those the same ones that I've already got, or are those something different? Here's the ones that I've already got. Those are exactly the same. Okay, well, I guess I can make use of those. 10 pieces 5x7 prototyping paper, prototyping board. This was an auction. So I would have lowball bid on it and got it. I have to pay more attention to the descriptions, especially when I'm on a late night lowball bidding frenzy. Anyway, so that's pretty much exactly the ones that I already had. Hole diameter about 1mm. Yeah, it couldn't be any more descriptive, could you guys? But other than that, it's just standard experimenting perf board, which is always useful. Another one where Electronic parts quantity 1. That's all it says. Okay. Nothing else in there. What do we got? Sure packaged it well anyway. Well, that's not going to get hurt. I might get hurt opening it up. What got here? Oh. These are, let's zoom in. These are a whole bunch of lithium charge modules. I've got some other ones that I got earlier. These ones have the advantage of, so they've got the charge side over here, or plus and minus 5 volts in. And they've got the battery plus and minus to a standard 3.7, I think, lithium ion battery, which could be any number of salvaged ones from cell phones, like I've got a bunch of here. What does that guy say? It doesn't say. Or, let's just zoom back out. Or it could be your standard 18650, also salvaged in this case from a laptop. So it will charge the battery from there with charge protection so it doesn't overvoltage it. And then the output should be, is that output going to be 3 volt battery voltage or is it going to be boosted? Not seeing. Focus. Thank you. Not seeing an inductor for a booster, so I'm going to have to look these things up and find out what's going on. 10 pieces lithium charging board from our good friend Alice, 110-1983. $4.74 Canadian, $3.58 American for 10 pieces. So what's that work out to? 47 cents each, free shipping. I'll take it. What do we got down here? 1 amp, 5 volt. Okay, input voltage is 5. Maximum charging current is 1,000 milliamps. Cutoff charging voltage is 4.2 volts, plus or minus a percent. Okay, good. So we got overcharge, charge cutoff, battery overcharge protection 2.5. I'm going to guess that's under protection at 2.5. Over current protection at 3 amps. Neat. Okay. So it does have over voltage and over current. So I've got my lithiums hooked up there just temporarily. And I got a source of 5 volts to charge it from. So there's that. So I'm going to guess that should be 5 volts minus a diode. Oh yeah, that's pretty much the 5 volts coming in off of there. Now then the battery plus and minus will be, excuse my reach. Okay, charging, yeah, cool. And the output voltage. Well, that's also the battery voltage. Okay. So then if I unplug that guy, so it's not charging. What do we got here? That's nothing from the 5 volts. The output is 4.10, 4.11. And the battery is 4. Okay. So that's just parallels the battery. Presumably, I'm hoping that it has an over-discharge protection circuit on there. Because those two outs there I can put to a boost converter. I got a bunch of those kicking around to give me 5 volts or whatever I want. As a matter of fact, there's two of them up there right now. One that's powering this thing from this old Nokia battery. And one that's powering that thing, which I could have used actually for this instead of the battery. Let's just do that just for the fun of it. Hmm. Not working. Why is it not working? Because that's not plugged in. There we go. Okay. So now we have this battery through the boost converter, charging that charging this battery through the charge controller. Slick. Now then, I could also, like I said, hook that type of a boost converter up to those outputs and get 5 volts back out of it. Neat. I like it. All right, what's next? How about this? This is bottle. Oh. Okay. Oh, these. Yeah, okay. These are chemical pump bottles. You just put your chemical down inside there, and as you tap the lid, it pulls it up from inside and pumps it out into a little well on top there, which you can pick up with whatever you want. And I'm gonna have to check the listing. Oh wait, no, this is HDPE and 50 milliliters, 100 milliliters. Okay, so I don't think I will be using that for MEK or probably not even paint thinner, but alcohol, which I use for cleaning a whole bunch, both cleaning circuit boards off, but more for cleaning model railroad stuff. That's what that's going to be for. Not sure what I'm going to put in the other one yet. So up until now, I've just had alcohol in this little eyedropper bottle, and actually another one full of just water. So maybe I'll just stick with those two things. Now then, there we go, and got a little swab for cleaning whatever it is that needs cleaning, which probably would be this guy. Neat. I like it. And that can just sit back there. Cool. This one, I'll figure it out later. Okay, 120 milliliter ESD. Really? Plastic alcohol bottle, solder flux bottle, industrial liquids bottle. The price. $1.23 for one. I bought two of them. Or $1.63 Canadian from Ochan's VIP. Ochan's something. Anything interesting about it? Anti-static generating. The pump is stainless steel. It's HDPE mixed with an anti-static compound. Ideal for EPA and clean room environments. Well, my shop is pretty much the opposite of a clean room environment, so I think it should manage. And the humidity around here doesn't allow for too much static, so I'm not too worried about that either. Special design to avoid the liquid reflux. Made of plastic and stainless steel, capacity 120 milliliters or 100 milliliters, depending on which line you read. Alright, what do we got here? Description, shrink tubing. Okay, I know what this is. Oh, it is in fact shrink tubing. I cut one of them in half. It's tiny shrink tubing, but it's shrink tubing. Okay, well, I can use that. I use an awful lot of this 22 gauge wire, which is telephone wire or the guts of Cat 5. And that will work for stuff that size. Okay. That's smaller than I was expecting. Again, I don't know whether that's the description in the listing or just my fault or a bit of both. But if I remember correctly, I got these as an auction, and I got it for dirt cheap, so I'm not too concerned about it. What do we got here? Two for 6 colors. Okay, neat. I will have to add that to my shrink tubing collection or accumulation, which already has a bunch of different sizes. What's that? 2 millimeter, an assortment. That one's 1/4 inch, which is that stuff. So I've got a pretty good assortment already. This will add some smaller stuff to it. Grand. Heat shrink tubing, 6 colors, 0.6 millimeter, 1 meter each, I guess. So 33 cents Canadian, 25 cents American. That was an auction. That's why it was so cheap. And I guess I just didn't pay too much attention to this 0.6 millimeter. But oh well, I can still use it. It's not a big deal. 1 meter, white, black, red, yellow, green, blue. Not much more to say about shrink tubing, really. Okay, a couple more here. Customs declaration says battery holder. I do this without slicing. Oh, there's 2 different kinds of things in here. What do we got? Oh, I remember now. Yeah. This one is a bunch of 18650 holders. So, which end's positive? I can never remember on these. Okay, that's the positive end there, the end of the little groove on it. The negative end is back there. Okay. And actually, that arrived in perfect time to work with these guys. Nice. So what is there? 1, 2, 3, 5 of them in there. Okay. What was the other thing that was in that same package? Oh! What are you? Aluminum case. Plastic battery box that looks like it holds 4 18650s, does it? One, two, three, four. Okay. I got here 5 volts, 2 amps, 5.1, 2 amps, 3.6 volts, which is that at 1040 milliamp hours or whatever. Okay, and a little cover. And what's happened here? There we go. I'll zoom back in on that again. So, charging input, 5 volt output. Presumably, that guy is a charge controller and boost buck or boost converter. Okay. But there's no battery terminals, no battery wiring. Battery just goes on B plus and B minus, which is fine. That means I'm going to have to, you know, I've got a few more of those that I've salvaged from a laptop battery. I got another laptop battery to salvage out of, so that should be probably another 6 18650s in there. So 5 and 4 is 9. I should be good. I've got, okay, so now to actually use this guy, I'm going to have to put 4 in parallel. Oops, that way around. Thank you. And I'm going to have to solder across them on both the positive and the negative ends to put them all in parallel. Or I mean, I could just put 1 in there, but why waste the amp hours if I've got 4? It's That's a nice little case too. So that slides in there like that. Okay, there's a little cookie button up there, which meets up with that. So that little circuit board is going to notch into there somehow. Oh, they just haven't. Okay, that's still got the end from the fab. So back to slotting that in there. That. Snaps in on top. I guess you get to be your own manufacturer and print your own graphics on there. And then that whole guy. Oh, I see. That snaps on after it's in the case. So that jams in there like that. And then that snaps on there. Oh, that is... that is neat. 18650 battery holders with wires. 5x plastic battery holder case storage box. Mm-hmm. From Access Market. That cost me $1.80 Canadian or $1.36 American for the five of them, which is pretty cheap. Oh, and a whole 19 American cents or 2 bits Canadian for shipping. And again, it's not a super duper high-tech device. It's a battery holder. What else is there to say about it? And here is the 18650 kit, I guess you'd call it. Power bank case set, 4x18650 battery charger. I guess I chose the black one. I don't know. Maybe I didn't choose and they just randomly sent me one. Anyway, $2.50 Canadian, $1.89 American from Access Market. What do we have to say? This one we might actually have specs on it. Aluminum alloy shell, yes. Good touch and feeling. Shows your good taste. Sure, whatever. Support replacement of 18650s, yeah. Can also charge 18650s, power bank and recharger for 18650s, yeah, whatever. So 4x18650, input, so charging current 2 amps max, output 5 volts 2.1 max. That's reasonable. Okay, last one for today. From Singapore, with a sticker over top of the thing, which I've started to peel away. Description, gift. Well, that's not very useful. I mean, it's cool that they're cheating the government out of their import duties, I guess. But it doesn't tell me what it is. Oh, ho, 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 ho. It's more of those modules. As kits. Oh, those are different ones. Not really kits either. Yeah. And they came with some jumpers. I can't remember, what is this? Max 721 or 7219, right. So basically, the data just, where is, so that guy mounts on top of there. I'll have to take a look, look-see, but basically, our matrix mounts on those pins there, if that pin wasn't bent. We have, why did I zoom out? We have no focus. There we go. Clock chip select data in ground and VCC. Coming in and going back out. So we can gang these along. And this time, instead of just buying two, I got four. So, if I remember, where'd my box go? When did I order these? It, of course, doesn't say. Okay, I think I ordered them shortly after I built that one, which you can scroll back through the videos and see when that was, but it was 2 or 3 months ago. But my plan was to just build a larger version of that and probably not stuck on a breadboard haphazardly like that. But, yeah, so that's what those are doing. Okay, 2 pieces max 7219 dot matrix module. Arduino microprocessor. Well, microcontroller? Yeah, no, they're not. They can be used with anything that can create serial data. Actually, since it clocks stuff in, you don't even need a microcontroller. You could do this with push buttons if you were really, really insane. From GoWin Electronic, $3.65 Canadian, $2.76 American. Two of them in a package, or two of them together, and I bought two of those, so I ended up with four of them, like I said. These ones have the blue circuit board rather than the red circuit board. The red circuit board, that one. That's the one that I have on my bench already with the sign. But this blue one is the one that I got. These ones with the dip is a full kit that hangs out the back. The one that I bought is a surface mount, and it's already pre-soldered. All I have to do is solder on the LED module and the header pins. 5 volts, four screw holes, five modules with input and output. I don't know what that means. I think that's talking about a different one. But, come here. So 5 volts ground, data in, chip select, and clock. Yeah, there's nothing different about those. And there are several different varieties of them. Oh, they also do this 16 grid pack of them. That might be interesting, but not for $35. Anyway, those are going to be a fun little thing to play with in the future, too. And there's all the stuff from this episode's mailbag. That's excellent. Thanks for watching.